things that you have learned in responding to this week was a tremendous week of prayer. And oh, I just got so happy this week. Amen. If you want to hear me cry or see me cry or holler or get happy, amen, you have to come in early in the morning. That's the time your anointing is really, really flowing. I know some of you say, well, I don't want to see you happy that bad to come in early. But the early bird normally, you know, that's what they say, catches the worm. So it's just good. We're praying that God will really begin to stir us. And we have a real goal this year of really reaching more people than we've ever reached before. And we believe that in order for us to be anointed and led of God, that's the secret in being successful in the kingdom of God. Let me tell you, it's not easy out there trying to reach people and winning them to Jesus Christ. Amen. In this day, it's just a real challenge. And you have to be led of God. God has to do this in you. Amen. Because your smart wits and your clever schemes and methods will never cut the mustard. You gotta do it the same way Jesus did it. Amen. Jesus did all of the works that he performed. He did them through the power of what? The Holy Spirit. Amen. He says that I cast out devils by the Spirit of God. Well, you can't cast no devil out in the power of your own strength. So that's the reason why I think it's so important for us to pray and wait before the Lord and place ourselves in a position where God's power can really work through us uninhibited, you know, without restrictions and without hindrances. And that's what prayer is designed to do, to place you in a position where God's grace can really flow and be released through you. And that is the motivation, because the scripture says we can do all things through who? Christ, that what? Strengthens us. Amen. So that is the message I have this today that I'm going to begin to share with you. Following the example of Jesus. Everybody just said with me, following the example. Amen. I see that you're really excited about following this example too. Amen. How much you're not going to say it, because you know that following the example of Jesus means that it's going to be a price you have to pay. There's a commitment that you have to make. It's not going to be easy. Amen. We used to sing this song years ago, "Where He Leads Me, I'll Follow." Amen. I haven't heard nobody sing that lately. Amen. Not that they don't believe that, but I don't hear it sing. So today, I want to call your attention to the Word of God. And I'm going to give you a few scriptures. Sometimes we give you more scriptures than other times, but I think the Word of God is very important. The scripture says the Word is life to them that find it. Amen. The Word of God is life to them that find it, and is healing to all of their flesh. Amen. Sister Hill, I left my Bible. I'm not sure if I left it on the seat or back in the bag. Amen. But this is the message that we've been sharing recently. Let me just, you know, most of these scriptures, I've prayed them so much, and I've sang them so much, until they are just a part of me, and I can quote them, and I can relay them, even without reading them. Amen. So, we've been speaking about the compassion of the Lord and how he was always moved with compassion. The Bible has many, many scriptures. Sister Hill, that's okay. I do like I do at home. It's right here. I have it right here, darling, to be here. But this scripture really blessed me. And you know, this morning as Brother Dean and were concluding praise and worship, I just felt like God really, really wanted to work a little longer. And like it was just a good atmosphere. If somebody had just broke through a little louder, I mean, I believe that everybody would have went up in worship. So the scripture says the kingdom of God suffereth what? Violence. But the violent will what? Take it by force. Amen. Sometimes we have to press through the hindrances and the limitations and get through so we can get, amen, the real anointing released in our lives. Amen. I want you to turn to Philippians. I'm going to have a word of prayer, but I feel like I've already prayed through, but I'll pray again. Father, we thank you for leading and directing all that we say and all that we do. Let everything be done to your will and to your glory in Jesus' name. Everybody say, in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen. Scripture says here in Philippians 2, it says, look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. And there's another scripture. I want you to turn to 2 Corinthians. And this is the 5th chapter. And I'm going to read the 14th and the 15th verses. It says this. For the love of God constraineth us, because we thus judge that if one died for all, then we're all dead. And that he died for all, they that which live, I mean, that's us, they which live should not henceforth live unto themselves. Amen. But unto him which died for them and rose again. So this scripture is saying that they that live should not live unto themselves. That's the mind that Jesus had. Scripture says, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. All right, if you would go to the 1 John, I want to read a scripture. I wish I could just read all of these scriptures, but time will not permit me to read all of these scriptures. But this scripture is found in 1 John 5, verses 15. Let me go back. 1 John 3, verses 16 and 17. I'll do that one first. And 1 John 4, 7 through 11. Okay? Hereby proceed we the love of God, because he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. In other words, it's just saying that we're not to live just for our selfish reasons, just for all of the attention centered around us. The scripture says that we are not to withhold good from them to whom it is due when it is in the power of your hand to do it. So selfish living really produces a very limited, gloomy, and unhappy life. And you live just for yourself. All of the attention, all of the efforts you put forth is mainly focused around the things that pertains to you and your family and your interest, personal interest. That is going to be a very selfish type life. You're not going to be happy. And let me tell you, love is something that makes you real happy. When you can really share and reach out to people and sow into their lives and follow the example that Jesus shared, amen, that's the thing that makes you full and complete and really makes your life all that it needs to be. Amen. All right. This scripture, 1 John 4, verse 8, 7, let's start there. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. Oh, that's a powerful scripture. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. In this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him. Herein is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. That's the sacrifice of the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we ought also to love one another. Amen. Amen. So that is a very powerful passage. Now, I want to announce my subject again, following the example of Jesus. We've been talking about how God, how the Lord Jesus, and how the Father God, Scripture says they're full of compassion. They are full of what? Compassion. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. So that spirit that dwells in us will also, if we have the life of God in us, is going to constrain us. It's going to move us in that same realm where we're going to be touched with the feelings of the concerns and the needs of others. See, the scripture says Jesus was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. So he tells us that we should come boldly before the throne of grace so that we can receive mercy and grace to help us in the time of need. And the Bible says that he's touched with the feelings of our needs. He's touched with the feeling, amen, of our needs. Amen. The feelings of our infirmity. God is what? Touch. Amen. The Bible says it's God's good pleasure to give us what? The kingdom. Is that right? Yeah. Amen. So God is not a giver. He's not a withholder. He's a person that's for you. Amen. Just touch somebody and say, God is for you. Some of y'all might not understand what I mean. In other words, God has what? Has your back. He is really rooting for you. Amen. In other words, he has made every provision. Everybody say every provision.
Every
provision imaginable. He has already paid the price, made every provision, and done everything that he needs to do in order to make every blessing possible available to you. That's the purpose of him laying down his life. That was the purpose for him. Amen. The scripture says, when we were yet without sin, in due time, Christ what? He died. He died because he wanted every need that we will ever have, amen, to really be released into our lives. And under the old covenant, God made provision. He was Jehovah under the old covenant. He was Jehovah. Jehovah what? Nisi. Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Sitkanil. Jehovah, amen, Jireh. All of these Jehovahs simply mean that God had made provisions for every blessing. I mean, every blessing that you will ever have need of. Yes. Yes. Amen. How many know you have? You need peace. Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. If you got peace, you don't have too much going for you. Scripture says that he will keep us in what? Perfect peace. Provisions has been made for your peace.
Amen.
Amen. Scripture says, be anxious for nothing, but in all things, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. Let the request be made known. Amen. It's just that simple to turn things around when you are disturbed, when you're frustrated, when you're full of anxiety. The scripture says that you can cast all your care Amen. Bible says the Lord God is a sun and a shield. He gives you what? Grace.
Glory.
Amen. How many know grace is what? The sum total. S-U-M. Total. T-O-T-A-L. Sum total of everything God has done for us through Jesus. He covers every base. Somebody said his grace is sufficient. Apostle Paul said, I am what I am because of the grace of God. How many know that his grace, if somebody, amen, that son, sister, daughter, saint, it reaches to the highest mountain, the blood. Everything is based on the blood. Y'all know that, right? It reaches to the highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. The blood that gives me strength from day to day. It will never lose its power. Amen. You know, we can just go back and just articulate scripture after scripture where God has clearly revealed to us his willingness to meet every need that we will ever have from the time that we enter here on this earth scene until we finally depart from this life and enter into eternity. And he got it fixed where even in eternity, it's going to be better in eternity than it is down here now. The Apostle Paul said, eye hasn't seen it. Glory. Neither ear has what? Heard. Neither even has it entered into the heart of men the things that the Lord has prepared. Oh, he has done a good job of preparing. Oh, hallelujah. David said he prepared a table, what? Before me. In the presence of mine enemy. How many know God can prepare stuff like he can get you set up for a blessing? Every good and every perfect gift comes from what? From above. Amen. So we have to keep our minds on the blessings. I was in a home yesterday. I was praying with a lady that had much pain. And she was living her life in so much fear. And she was saying that, I just stay frustrated. I'm just full of anxiety. Because I never know when the last minute will come. Amen. She's going through a very serious illness. And she began to question me, well, how does it feel when you die? And she really began to, that was really disturbing her. And I told her, amen. The word of God says, fear not, neither be thou dismayed. Yes. Yes. Fear not. Yes. God hasn't given us the what? The spirit of fear. But of what? Power. Love. Sound man. So I had to get her out of fear. Woo, Lord. How many know the only thing that can get anybody out of fear is the what? The word of God. Oh, that's the reason why the Apostle Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ because it is the power, woo, power of God. Hey, unto salvation. Amen. That's what I told her. Well, the work of righteousness shall be what? Peace, the effects of it, what? Quietness and assurance forever. Amen. I said that God is able to keep you in perfect peace because he made this declaration. He said, fear not, neither be thou dismayed, for I am thy God. Ain't that precious? I am thy God. That's enough to make you weep. I am thy God. He's my God. Hallelujah. I will help you. I will strengthen you. And I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness. How many know that God's right hand is real strong? Oh, hallelujah. How many know that God's right hand is what? Real strong. Amen. You heard Brother Shambach give this illustration. He said that, amen, before the devil can get us out of God's hand, God got us right there in the palm of his hand. That right hand, that's the, amen, that symbolizes what? Strength and power. He said, before the devil can get you out of God's hand, he said he has to run down the arm of Jesus and pry open the hand of God. And he has to wade through the blood. Hey! And by the time he runs down God's strong arm, hey, glory, and pry open the hand of God and wade through the blood, the devil will be saved himself. And speaking in tongues. In other words, he was saying there's no way the devil can get you out of what? God's name. Amen. Praise God. How many glad that God, hallelujah, God got you in the palm of his hand. That's the reason why we say no weapon but formed. Amen. Turn around and tell somebody no weapon formed against you. Settle down. Tell them to settle down. Settle down. Let your problems go. Cast them all on what? Jesus. Amen. I know. I don't know what to do with them. Don't bring them to me. Bring them to me. I want to take them right to Jesus. Glory. He's able, what? Praise God, to do exceeding abundantly of all that you can think or ask. How many glad that God is able? And the thing I like, God is not just able. Amen. Sister Hill is able to. Amen. All right, Sister Hill always got a smart answer, don't I? She's able to go home and cook me a steak dinner. She's able. But the problem is she might not be willing to go. In fact, I don't believe she would be doing that. We got some food in the bag. We got some good old pinto beans. I hope so, see you like this. Are they pinto? Okay. All right. So we got all of our friends. Everybody can join us. We got plenty of beans. But the part I like is that God is not just able, but he is willing. That's good. When we say God is willing, scripture says he's able to do exceeding abundantly above. You know, that sounds really good. But when he says he's willing, that brings it what? A little closer within your what? Grasp. He is willing. So for him, are you willing? She says, come on. But God is not just able, he is more than able. If you know somebody able just seems like, well, maybe they can, you know, maybe they can muster up enough what strength to meet whatever need I have. Maybe they can somehow. If they scrape and try hard enough. So it's, but willing, it gives it a little bit more what? Intensity. Is that right? God is willing. Amen. Hallelujah. How many can say God is willing? In other words, he wants to do it. But I can take it even further than just able. I can take it further than willing. I can say that he's eager. It's God's good pleasure. He gets pleasure in the prosperity of the servant. Amen. He's full of eager yearning. So that brings us to the point where this is the thing that God wants us to be motivated by. Amen. It's not enough for God to be compassionate and merciful as eyes running to and fro. We know all of the scriptures. Eyes are running to and fro throughout the whole earth. And he's looking for the heart that is what? Perfect before him. In other words, he's looking for somebody that's willing to place themselves in a position where his blessings and his mercy and his love can reach him. Amen. You know, wouldn't it be good if God would just pull out all of his blessings on anybody under any circumstance, any condition? Regardless of whether you believe or not, or whether, amen, you hated God, or amen, was a God curse or whatever, But God said, I'm looking for somebody that will place themselves in a position. Amen. Come here, Brother Curtis. Amen. I'm looking for somebody that will place themselves in a position. Now, the position that he placed himself in, he's getting better, walking better. Amen. And probably wouldn't have the deliverance and blessings that he has and have now. And get up on your knees and let's see if it kind of hurt you to stoop over. All right, so he's been in the world. He ain't grunting. So whenever you place yourself in a position, and the way I do it, I come, as, you know, every morning that I can. Usually I try to make it every morning. Okay, the reason why I come, I'm placing myself in a position where God's power can flow in certain areas of my life. I want a real heart for souls. And I'm going to tell you that the compassion and the fervency and the zeal and the whatever we need in order to be effective as soul winners, it doesn't come automatically. See, having God's interest at heart, you know, the main thing God wants to see, he wants to see people saved. It's God's will that all men be what? Saved. Amen. Yes. All men, that's God's highest will and highest goal. He wants all saved. And he wants us to do whatever we can do or to place ourselves in a position where we can what? Effectively, amen, operate on a measure, in a measure, where we would be able, amen, to rescue people that are dying without Christ. Amen. Now, let me just, the second most important thing to God's heart is that souls be filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yes, he wants to speak in tongues, praying in tongues, because if you don't pray in tongues, get in the Spirit and really begin to release yourself and get the mind of God. The Bible says the eyes of our understanding needs to be what? Enlightened. If a person doesn't approach it from a spiritual standpoint, I mean prayer, get in the Spirit, your prayer will be a lot more meaningful. It will be a lot more fulfilling. You will get down to the nitty-gritty of your life and really begin to what satisfy that deep longing and that hunger that you have within. Hallelujah. Amen. See, Satan's power over your life is not going to be released easy all the time. How many can understand? Sometimes you have to what pray with intensity.
Amen.
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 Amen. Everybody with me?
Amen.
I will then say the kingdom of heaven suffered what? Violence. But the what? Violent. By force. The violent.
Amen.
Boy, I get violent sometimes.
Right.
Some of y'all say, oh, poor Pastor Hill. He sounds like he don't even have a friend in the world. Crying out to God. I be pulling out my heart. Because I want to be, the Bible says, he makes us able ministers of the new covenant. And I know if I place myself in a position where he can make me able and complete, Bible says we are complete in him. But you're not going to be complete just twiddling your thumbs and just counting sheep and just, you know, kind of passing the time away in prayer. Bible says the effectual fervent of the righteous, the effectual fervent of the effectual fervent prayer. The effectual what? Fervent prayer of the righteous man does what? He does much. So I know the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, but the vital will take it by force. So that means that you don't be passive in prayer. You pray through until what? Victory comes. When victory comes, the joy comes, the peace comes, the victory comes, the wisdom comes, the direction, the revelation comes. Amen. The power of the anointing comes. How many can say amen?
Amen.
And that is the purpose of prayer, because I mean finances come. Amen. It was the other day, I needed $100. Amen. I was running about $100 short. And in fact, I was running about $300 short. I should have thought about Sister Holman. But it didn't come to me. And then he was a gentleman from Moline, he called. He said, Pastor Hill, I got $175 for you. And I want to know how to send it. Do I send it by mail, or how do I send this? I would say, if by mail, I won't get it until next week. And I need this money right now. Amen. So the Lord just quickened that, in prayer, it kind of helps, because the Lord said, well, just have them to wire to your bank. Wire to your bank. Bank to bank. Got on the phone? I said, I got the answer. Go to your bank, and here is the routing number, and the bank number, and this number, and all of them, and those numbers. Here's my account number. Put it in my account. I went to the bank later on. The money was there. And all I needed was another $100. And this lady down in Beg somewhere called. She said, I'm sending $100 by this pastor that's here. I said, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Well, the Bible says he supplies all of our needs according to his what? Riches in glory through who? Christ Jesus. Well, the Bible says God takes pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. The word also says that it's God's good pleasure to give me the kingdom. Amen. Whatever I need, Bible said the kingdom of God is not what? Meat and drink. But it's what? Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. I'm going to tell you, amen, the more you stay in that vein where the anointing is flowing and the Bible says that the eyes of your understanding is what? Being enlightened through prayer, then the easier it is for God to get these blessings what? To you.
Amen.
My God shall supply all my need. How many can say amen?
Amen.
According to his what? Riches in glory. I could give you 12 miracles that have happened the last 2 or 3 weeks.
Come on.
I mean money miracles. Amen. As long as I was just showing up, you know, whenever it was convenient, seemed like nothing happened. But when I placed myself, when I say I placed myself, when I came down here, when I made a sacrifice, and every morning God could speak to me, direct me, lead me, motivate me. Whenever I make connection, I make the right one, and the one that I can get, you know, my need met. He just what? Lead you. Glory. David said, the Lord is my what? Leader. He's my shepherd.
Yes, it is.
No, a shepherd is concerned about every need that his sheep has. Not just one. He's doing more than feeding. Whether he what? He watches. He's guiding. He leads him. Amen. He gets in trouble. He what? Pull him out. He needs healing. Get in a brow patch and get all cut up. He pours in oil. That's the reason he said, he restored my soul. Hey, hi, yeah. Oh, he prepared the table. I'm going to stay on that for a while. Somebody here need to prepare the table prepared. How many got some needs today? Needs to be met. Hallelujah. He prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Hallelujah. My cup runs over. I'm going to tell you, I have more joy. My God, I'm going to tell you, the ministry is probably harder now than ever since I've been here in all these 30-some years. Because people are different. Saints are different.
All right.
Glory.
All right.
Everything is different.
All right.
But he prepares a what? Table. Boy, my cup runs over. I don't know where all this joy comes from. But I know it's working because what everything that I need, glory, the Bible says that, amen, this is a confidence that I have in him, that if I ask anything according to his will, he heareth me. Oh, it's good to know that God's eyes are open and his ears are open to your cry. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, I got more joy than I ever had in my life. More pressures, more challenges, more things that I could worry about than ever in my life. And I'm just really tickled pink by my little wife here. Yeah, she's following me in this happy ram too. I tell you how they talk to her in the morning. She said, you got to get in her Bible. Sometimes I might want to say a little love something. Boy, I mean, sometimes it seems like it's hours and hours straight. But I know weeping may endure for a night, but what joy comes in the morning. The Bible says God is going to perfect that thing that concerns me. He's going to perfect it.
Yeah.
He who has begun a good work in me.
Yeah.
Woo! Glory.
Yeah.
How can I believe that God has done a good work in me?
Yeah.
Come on, to keep on rejoicing. Keep on praising God.
Yeah.
Keep on delighting yourself in him.
Yeah.
And the Bible says he's going to what? Give you.
Yeah.
Come on. Amen. This is best brother here. He came out here. My first morning, he was out here. Amen. He's the one that making all this money. He was the first one. That was Monday or Tuesday. I mean, he was there. He knows that what all the Lord is blessing with. It didn't come just by, happenstance. He know that was a price he paid.
Yes, amen.
He had to lay down his life.
Yes, amen.
He said there a whole lot of time. He didn't have what he wanted to eat. His house, amen, wasn't nothing like what he wanted to say, what he wanted to be. Sometimes the furniture, all of these years, he was down in the dust when he first started out. Amen. But he prayed himself out, believed himself out. It's hard to tell how many mornings he showed up here.
Amen.
Amen. Before that money started rolling in, that big. No, I'm just putting words in. I'm embarrassing there. Because he never talks about what God blessed him. Although God is blessing me, victim, I can't say it because people might get the wrong idea. That's very wrong. All right. Well, I'm crazy. I'm just as happy as I can be. I don't know. Amen. I just can't, amen, go too much further. I'm just as happy as I can be. Jesus is making me real happy, y'all. He's giving me real victory.
Amen.
Amen. I don't know how many preachers I've talked with recently. Some wanted me to come for a revival. But I say, if I go for a revival, amen, I might go prematurely before God fill my cup completely up. I want my cup running over. If it's running off of Sister Sheridan. Oh, hey, but I don't want to leave until I get Sister Sheridan running up and down these aisles in the morning. It's happening. That the blessings of the Lord make it up for rich. I want to see some rich blessings pouring out on Northside folk before I start going up and down the road and flying here and there. Amen. I believe if I do my homework, I believe I have something to offer when I leave. How many can say, if I can get you happy, if I can get you broke, prayed through, if I can get you focused, if I can get you, amen, we're going to talk about in our meeting very shortly, we're going to talk about all of the different things that God has just laid in our pathway to bring us into the area of evangelism. Amen. It's not going to be a hard task. God is, amen. I want to tell you the truth. Y'all pray for me. Many times you come to the point you just don't know what to do. You can always come up with some kind of plan or scheme and do this or do that. But I believe it's best when you don't know what to do, just pray God will what? Show you.
Amen.
He'll show you. He'll show you. Now remember, $10,000 need real bad. So you can tell you. And I sought the Lord, and the Lord said, just pray. Just pray. Stay in the Word and pray. He said, I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you.